So, you want to be a paranormal investigator? Season 2, episode 1. Okay, so what I've done is I've downloaded the 8 colors, the paranormal colors. Now, this is an old school thing. Yeah, this was before you had the SB7 box and the radio fixes and all that stuff. Basically, all we had was the different. The different color noises, eh? Like pink noise, brown noise, white noise, all that stuff. Anyway, technology is both good and bad, okay? It's always both good and bad. Now, with the SB7 box and the radio hack shacks and all that stuff that's come out, it's fantastic because it's instant results, right? So in a lot of ways, it's fantastic, because you get that right away, you know, and you get good responses and everything else. The downsides of it, of course, is there is a lot of bleed through, you know, but there is a difference between bleed through and logical, direct answers, and which we all know, okay. But there is bleed through, and the other thing is, because of the bleed through, you miss out on stuff that you get from the noise, okay? However, something to be said about the old school way using the noise. Now, I put all 8 colors on this cinema, so all you gotta do is just play it when you go on an investigation or play it in your house. That's all we used. So the spirits knew that that's what we used to communicate. So we would get one word answers now and then, and every once in a while you could actually have a conversation. Not often, but every once in a while you'd actually have a full sentence, or you'd be able to talk and get a couple answers out of the deal, right? Which is amazing, right? Because there's no bleed through or anything. But a lot of times you sit there and sit there and sit there and get squat. Okay, that's the downside of it. You don't get as much communication at all. But sometimes you do, and when you do it, it's fantastic. You know, it's excellent because there's no way it's bleed through or anything because it's just noise. The other thing that you get more common than actual speaking to you is you will hear footsteps. Okay. Because there's a spirit in the room that's walking, and you'll actually hear the echo of their footsteps coming through the white noise or the pink noise. Doors opening and closing, you can hear. If they toss a rock, you'll actually hear it bounce through the noise. Okay? So there are certain things by using these that, you know, and it's really surprising when you hear footsteps coming through there, you know, and stuff like that. And the other thing is, with the white noise, it has to be in the same building. So if you're hearing footsteps, they're in the same building as you. You know, they're like 10 feet away from you or whatever. Okay, if you hear doorknob turning, if you hear door slamming, they're in the same building. Okay, so that's one benefit to using the different noises. So this is an old school way of doing it. I put all 8 on there, and I think each one's only like 4 minutes long, and there's 8 of them, okay? So they're about 4 minutes long, all in all. So you could just go on your next investigation and play the whole thing and just, you know, ask questions, and, you know, you could say, could you say hello? Maybe you can walk towards me so I can hear your steps. Could you throw something so I can hear it? Like, you can do all kinds of stuff with this. So have a lot of fun with it. Check it out. You'll probably have to use it for a while before it starts actually working for you personally. But yeah, I'm gonna be using mine quite a bit every day for the next 3 or 4 weeks. Try to see if I can get some good evidence for you. And when I do, I will show it to you on the channel, of course. Okay? All right. Okay, so until next time, we'll catch you later. Bye-bye.